The Geula cannot come as long as Amalek exists. But the Geula can come as long as the Erev Rav exists. You see the difference? The Amalek is part of the Erev Rav. Which means if we destroy Amalek, then the Geula can come. If Amalek exists, Geula cannot come. But the Geula, the redemption can come, even while the Erev Rav is still here. And of course, either they're going to be completely destroyed, or they'll do tshuva. Amalek can't do tshuva. Amalek has to be destroyed. But the rest of the Erev Rav, we can make them do tshuva. We. Moshe Rabbeinu, Mashiach Tzidkenu, he can make them do tshuva. But the rule is that the redemption cannot come as long as Amalek exists. So it says here that the name of Hashem is going to be complete, can only be done when? Achar mechiyat Amalek, after we destroy Amalek. Dichtiv, where do we learn this from? That it says in the book of Shmot, chapter 17, it says, Ki yad al kesya milchama la Hashem. Translation, for there is a hand on the throne of the Eternal, and there should be war for the Lord against Amalek. Right? The war is Hashem's war. It's not our war. You can do anything against Amalek. He will eat us alive within 1 second. The war is Hashem's war. And Hashem is going to destroy them. And the war has to be, this war is every generation. Can you imagine the patience of Hashem? How much generations? Anyways, it says, our sages have said, Amru Chazal, Shenishba Kadosh Baruch Hu. Kadosh Baruch Hu gave us an oath. He swore. En Hashem Shalem, ve'en ha'kiseh shalem ad she'imachah shmo shel Amalek. The name of Hashem and the throne of glory cannot be complete till the name of Amalek and the existence of Amalek has to be completely destroyed.